Hello. Hello, good evening. We are yet again, once again, playing Monster Hunter in preparation for Sunbreak. My name is Limit. Welcome to Midnight Cruisin'. We're gonna chill out and play some Monster Hunter while we listen to some jams. Also, if anybody wants to join, exclamation point join is your button. Alright, so I was fiddling with some builds last time we played, i.e. 2 days ago. Right? This is sort of like my normal build, quote-unquote. Which is, I'm not too happy about. Because we do have Handicraft 4, Critical Eye 4. It's like a mishmash of everything, sort of. I don't know if, because, hold on, 66% crit, but do I want that though? That's the problem. Well, let's change, because I could do either one of these. So I could either go for Teostra Blessing or Kushala Blessing, but it won't even reach it. Well, let's do some quests. Let's just do some quests. What is it? Okay. Right, let's see what we have pending still. We still have quite a few quests that I need to take care of. So maybe we'll do these, then we'll take care of these ones. I do have a lot of Rampage quests as well that are not yet cleared. Maybe we can do that as well. And we have a bunch of event quests that are definitely undone. So we have our work cut out for us. Lots of work. Lots of work. Alright, so, you know what? Let's begin with Rampage quests. Let's clear out these three real quick. I don't think I need to eat, right? I don't need to. I'm gonna do it anyway. What do they have? Let's get this. Let's get stuff that we could, like, grab things from. I guess that's the only thing. That's the only thing, really. Dango Summoner makes rare crafty creatures more likely to appear. Crafty creatures, you say? Hold on. Okay, let's do this, and then maybe... Yeah, I don't really like what's on the menu right now. Okay, then let's sell some of these items. Let's motley mix them, whatever I have in abundance. Oh, what the fuck was that? Oh, Mandragora? No, fuck that. I ain't selling that. Actually, you know what? It wouldn't hurt. It would not hurt to sell maybe 50 Mandragora? Let's see what happens. Let's see what they give us. Alright, not bad. 6 max potions. It's ultimately not worth, but you know what? I'll take it.
Oh. I do not mind it. There's quite a few things we need to make here too. Alright, let's depart. Yeah, I don't think there's anything that I need to like really take care of. Let's check here. Put one more here, I guess. Ooh. And then I guess that's it for the automatic ones. So for this one, I want my own. Yeah, we're ready. We're good to go. Okay, we have a Iori. I don't even know what a Iori does. Oh shit, Akensom, stop. Taiho! Yo, give me my cannon. Oh my goodness. Hold on. I wanna hold you so much. My long last love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be. There we go. Midnight cruising. We're midnight cruising. Hey, where's my cannon, sir? Wait, do I have to ring the bell here? I feel like I have to. Oh wait, I have this, really? This is not unlocked yet. I don't have the thing! Oh, there's the thing. Alright, here we go. Counter signal. Let's go. There we go. We have dragon bait. We have defender cannon. Alright. Really? I have 30 seconds! Oh, there you go, double counter signal, alright, lovely. gotta stop the Basarios from wrecking our shit. Stop this at once, sir. Oh my goodness, really? Stop. Okay, we have Nakta Sub coming in. Oh, get wrecked. It's gone, okay. Stop throwing fruit at me, Jesus! Okay, we gotta stop the Basarios. Oh, come on. I seriously had to- Oh my god, stop hitting my shit! Okay, we gotta put some cannons here. It's dangerous. We're in trouble. We're in bad shape right now. This is dangerous. Okay, we gotta prep. We actually gotta prep here. Hold the phone. I get it. Makasete. Okay, we have Wyvern Splitter. Good. Okay. That in there. Put this here. There we go. Mayonaka no doa takaki. Alright, we're ready. Oh my god, it's C-Jag! Hey C-Jag, what's up man? Hey, hello! Welcome guys! How are you guys? How was your evening? Yo guys, if you guys are watching this, follow my boy C-Jag, amazing guy. He has a very cute son, his name is Ezran. Also rode over but distracted by Ni No Kuni, alright. Hey not. Ni No Kuni's fun, not gonna lie. I enjoyed watching you guys play it. Mostly for the gambling. Yes, welcome C-Jag, welcome gang. Hello, I am. Ezra is big mad tonight, he was asleep, but not anymore. Oh no, why? What happened to him? Why he mad? It's just game, why he mad? Why the baby mad? What happened to him? Did you guys wake him? Did you guys wake him from his nap time? Does he even have a nap time? Oh god, I get him tossed around. Lurkin while I get him, put him back to sleep. Alright.
stay with me. Okay, you know what? This is gonna be problematic. We gotta shoot the big guns. Oh wait, actually it's not worth it. It's not worth it for two. Oh, I fucked up. I shot it anyway. God damn it. He's just teething right now? Aww. That's cute! He's cute! Very cute! He wishes you were there. I believe it. Uncle Nauseous. He has all the down low on the cool games, you know? Uncle Not has the down low. Uncle Chance. He's got all the secret tech. Of all the cool games. All the cool kids. He do be missing the unk. He's like a little over a year, right? But his Uncle Nick is here, so it doesn't matter. Ooh! Ooh! Uncle Nick! Uncle Nick! Oh no, are you gonna take that, Not? Are you taking that lying down? I know you're busy with Ni No Kuni, but are you gonna take that? In your own dojo. You're his first cousin once removed. I don't know if that's a diss. Not entirely sure. It's factual. Ooh, fair enough, fair. I personally don't have a lot of filial. Oh my goodness! Thanks for the biddies! Oh my goodness! Thank you so much, dude! Holy! My goodness! Thank you so much! You know what? Wait, you're lurking right now. If you come back, I'm gonna do a personality assessment for our boy C-Jag. Cause I know I'm not taking care of the baby right now. He is right, but you aren't his actual uncle. Ooh, oh, oh no. But real talk though, Uncle Not has all the game tech. See, here's the thing. In the year and years coming that I've known Nauseous, I have learned to like always trust his game recommendations, cuz man knows what he's talking about, you know? If he suggests something, hear it out. Is what I'm trying to say. Hear it out. He has a secret tech. You know what I'm saying? Like, you would be doing yourself a disservice if you don't at least hear out whatever his suggestion is. Give it a try. Give it the old college try. You know? Oh my god. Minoto, you know why you guys suck. Land your shit. The enemy is nowhere near here! What are you guys doing? The enemy's right here. Just yesterday, I put C-Jag into that Roller Champions. Ooh, actually, I think I saw that. I have always asked him for a suggestion for sure. Yeah. Yeah, I think I saw that. He was playing Roller Champions. It's fun. It's very hype, but with my eyesight situation, I don't think I can play it. It's too dizzying for me. But it does seem hype. You got a bit ragey. Yo, no, I can relate, man. Yo. Detractions to my character. Out of the things that I need to work on, I guess a better way to work on to word that. Rage is something that I think I need to put a bit more handle on. I think I'm evolving a little bit. Earlier this year, I had a blood pressure scare, so I kind of worked on that a little bit. So I think I'm better when it comes to getting angry. But you know, it's still there. It's still lingering, and it does rear its ugly head sometimes, especially with games. Not even games. Especially with like multiplayer games. I was gonna switch games. Then Ezran woke up. I try to switch games. If I get too heated, that's good. That's a good way of approaching things, to be honest. I tend to bash my head against the wall more. I tend to bash my head against the wall more, and it's just not working out. Oh no, we don't want to get famous here, sir. There we go. So that's one early quest done. But yeah, I do try to control my temper when I can. I just, like, not, I guess I've, you know, joke's on you. Oh, thank you. I don't think so, but sure, thank you. I appreciate that. But, yeah, like, honestly, yeah, rage is something that really needs some work on my end. Cause I'm gonna die if I don't fix it. I'm actually gonna die. I'm gonna get a stroke or something. Wait, what? What is this? What is this? Oh my goodness! Kingdom Reaper, thank you so much for following, my friend. Oh my goodness! Thanks, Kingdom Reaper. You're awesome. Welcome to the slam. I usually host fighting games. I host fighting game tournaments and I play Capcom games. That's what I do here. I hope you enjoy your stay. I hope you enjoy our little gamies here. Yeah, this hunt is not... These quests are not doing it for me. Rampages? Nah. Not at all, unfortunately. Maybe just not do them. Maybe just not do the Rampage quests. Have you guys ever played a Monster Hunter game? Well, not has, obviously, but... C-Jack, have you ever played a Monster Hunter game before? They're really fun. What did I just do? What did I just do? And a new one is coming out soon. The new expansion, Sunbreak. It comes out in 30 days. Yeah, can you guess who showed me MH? I'm guessing it's Nauseous. Mr. Chan's. It's fun. It's really fun. Which one did you play? Also, which weapon do you main? He got me back into it for World. Bow and Insect Glaive. Oh, Insect Glaive is fun. Bow is fun as well. My only issue with Bow is that you need arrows.
And it's kind of annoying to like keep, well, not arrows, powders. You kind of keep need to make powders, and it's yeah, you love to jump on monsters. Yeah, Insect Glaive is really good at that. Oh my goodness, I think I poured and a combination of my PS4 playthrough and my Steam playthrough for World and Iceborne, a little over 1,000 hours. I was dedicated, man. That was my shit. Iceborne was my shit. Like, I played to the point, I played up until the final expansion, the final monster, and they put Fatalis. And then I farmed a full Fatalis set. And then after that, like, there was nothing else to do. It was just, okay, it's over now. It's really, truly over now. And then I think a year after that, or maybe a couple of months after that, is when Rise came out. So it wasn't all bad. So now I'm putting a lot of hours in this one. What are my targets? A Magnemelo and a Wrath. Okay, let's take care of the Wrath first. In this game, they made jumping on monsters a lot more simplified. I mean, you still get the aerial maneuvers from Insect Glaive, and you still do manage to ride them using the same techniques, but everybody is afforded the ability to efficiently ride a monster. So much so that some of these fights you actually require to ride a monster, just to get you through the hurdle of their HPs. See, like this Rathalos over here. I missed. It's a tall one. Holy, this guy's tall. It's a tall Rathalos. It's a tall boy. NBA Rathalos. Yo, why am I stunned? Okay, hold on. I don't think... No, yeah, that's right. I forgot I didn't put the proper build in this one. Oh, well. No, the mistakes were made. Oh, well. I could probably use my other build for this one. Yeah, I should probably use my other build. So I have an ice build that doesn't allow me to be stunned. It's probably what I should be rocking right now. C-Jack, I heard you also did theater. What I usually work on, He can vouch for all my theater trauma because he had a front row seat. Ooh. I'm doing sound for Newsies for local community theater this summer. Oh. Newsies is a play? I feel like I've heard of that before. Musical. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I feel like I've heard of it before. It transformed. Have you been on stage though? Have you tried being on stage? Or is more of the technical side really your passion? I also use my trade experience to get my job as a sound technician at a local company. Ooh. That's pretty cool, man. I love doing on stage. It really pays. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I believe so. If you're not like an actor actively getting gigs, I guess. I'm assuming. Obviously, I'm not in that world. So I wouldn't really know. I'm just all of my anecdotes are just assumptions. But it would be nice. I did some in school, but it wasn't really, you know, I wouldn't call myself a theater kid, you know? Like, I dabbled, but I wouldn't be so bold to call myself as someone who's actively participating. I'm auditioning for more this year. Ooh. Volunteer for acting. What kind of projects are you going to be working on? Or at least the ones that you're applying for. Or auditioning for, rather. Rent and Christmas Carol. Oh. Is Rent the one with the like real talk, I tried singing the part, then I don't remember that I didn't know the lyrics. The one with the numbers. 569,000 something something. I'm sorry. I apologize. Oh no. It's that one, okay. I'm not very cultured, okay? All I know in life is anime and Kamen Rider. It's one of my favorites, so hope you get it. Oh, there we go. Man, I hope you get it. Real talk. That would be nice. And then, you know what? I'm gonna say when you get it. When will be the showing? When will that happen? Because I'm assuming there's gonna be rehearsals and whatnot, right? There's gonna be rehearsals and then the actual play. The actual musical. I keep saying play. And then it's a musical. Not until- Oh, that's so long! That's at least 8 months from now. And is it like a community thing? Auditions are in a couple of months, just trying to get ready. Ah. This Rathalos needs to die. It's our community theater, but the only one that pays. Ah.
it's a big production then, eh? How long do the shows usually run for? They just change it so actors and technicians get paid. Ah, that's good. Shows run 4 to 5 weeks. Oh, yo, that's pretty cool. Wednesday to Sunday shows. Oh look, we got the tail. So you get Monday and Tuesday off. I would assume the Monday, the Wednesday, Thursday shows aren't as packed, right? Because you'd probably get people that are like going out on dates or something. Like your big nights are the Friday to Sunday ones. That really amazes me, like, live performances like that. It's like, so many things can go wrong, right? Yeah, normally they run sales and promos to help out, but the best shows are Saturday and Sunday. Ah, not even Friday, eh? Goodness, why is this wire all over the place? There we go. What's like the biggest crowd that you've worked with? Sunday is an early matinee show normally too. Oh, oh really? Oh. Also, what's the kind of crowd that usually watches your shows? I apologize, I have so many questions. It's just I'm very curious because I've never really done anything like that, you know? So Not that it's a foreign world to me, it's just that I'm always a guy who's looking from the outside in, if that makes sense. You have a mix Sundays, or Sundays are an older crowd, I guess. Like folks coming in from, I guess, like, their places of worship or something. Or, I know, retirees, I guess. In Philadelphia, sometimes there's like 560 seats, though. That's insane. That's pretty wild. 560 seats? Damn, dude. That's honestly very, very amazing. So, like, as a sound tech, like, What usually, like, what are the things, like, I know it's gonna sound like very, like, dumb of me, but, like, just know that I am actually dumb, so I'm actually pretty curious. So aside from, like, I know you're, like, ensuring all the stereos and whatnot are working, like, what goes into, like, your job, if you don't mind me asking? Like, if you don't want to talk about it, it's fine. Like, I know it's sometimes it's kind of annoying to talk about work. I'm just like very curious. I'm just genuinely curious. Cause like I stream, right? But like I'm not like a big streamer. But I still need to dabble with like sound stuff, and like sound is one of the bigger mysteries for me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like very curious as someone who's actually doing it professionally. Like, what goes in your like day to day? For my day job, I set all of the equipment up and run the mixer. Ooh. So like, how does that usually work out? Like, I'm pretty sure depending on the situation, you need to present the audio in a different way, right? Like, say for example, sound for somebody who's maybe, say for example, holding a lecture would be different for sound of somebody who's like maybe singing or, you know, or a musical. Mostly do live sound, so I need to know my environment and audience. Oh. Like, what kind of example of an environment? Like, open air? That kind of stuff? But I would assume you would be working in a theater, no? For musical, you need to make a microphone plot and figure out who gets the mic. Oh, shit, that sounds all mapped out and shit. I'm already intimidated just hearing about it. And you have to, and I'm assuming you have to, like, make sure the person who's, like, actively speaking has the, has, quote-unquote, focus, right? Oh, missed it. The way you know how to turn up and turn down during the show, muting and unmuting? Ooh. So what's like the worst... What's the worst, like... Live fumble you've had to fix? Oh my goodness. For Newsys, it's an outdoor theater, so I don't have to worry as much about feedback. Okay. I've had entire speakers lose power and had to fix it mid-song. Oh, damn. How'd that work out? That's intense. Like, did you make it? Did you manage to fix it in time? That's pretty insane. It was a quick fix, luckily, so yes, it was fixed by the end of the song. Ooh. And
I'm assuming audiences are pretty understanding for the most part. But that would have been that would still have been very what word am I looking for? Nerve-wracking. How long have you been doing sound? Performer was really nice about it. He actually asked the audience to show me some love. Ooh, that's awesome. Yeah, I'm just imagining how that played out. Oh my goodness. Oh, do you watch anime, CJag? Do you watch anime, dude? I know there's a bit of left field. This is that there's an anime I think you'd really enjoy. Do you watch anime, my friend? You don't watch anime much, but I'm open to suggestion. Okay, there's this show, right? It's called Your Favorite is Full Metal Alchemist. Ooh, yo, that's a good one. FMA is really popular in Japan. but what I was gonna say, there's this new show. It's airing right now. It's not done yet. It's still currently airing. It's one of my favorites. It's a show called Ya Boy Kong Ming. I'm not even kidding, that's the title. Ya Boy Kong Ming. Also called Paripi Komei. So the plot is, I don't know how familiar you are with the Warring Kingdoms of China. Like way back when, you know, the Three Kingdoms, Sengoku, Basara, all that wacky stuff. So there's this tactician way back when in China. Su Gi Ling, I think his name is. In Japanese, his name is Komei. Well, in Chinese, it's Zugi Koming, something like that. Anyway, he dies, so it follows his normal, like, history, right? He dies, as per the history books say. And then, after he dies, he gets resurrected in modern-day Japan. You know. As per usual. but he doesn't get resurrected like he doesn't get resurrected from birth. Hold on. The part where your interest might come in is not in yet. So think about I guess in a better way to do it is like you've heard of Sun Tzu, I'm assuming. You know the guy who wrote The Art of War? So he's kind of like that, right? He's a tactician, he's a strategist for a Chinese kingdom. So he gets resurrected in modern day Japan, not from birth. He gets resurrected like in his mid 20s or some shit like that. But he still has his clothing from way back when he lived in old China, and then obviously the mannerisms and the knowledge of being from that era. Now, He resurrects in the middle of Halloween in Shibuya, Japan. So this is the city in Japan where there's a lot of like partying. Like it's a very popular city in Tokyo, where it's mostly like partying. All the nerd stuff, the cool stuff are all there. He resurrects in Halloween and he thinks he's in the underworld, right? Because everybody's in costume, right? It's Halloween, so people thought he was in costume too, because he's wearing weird ancient Chinese clothing. Now, what happens is, he gets. Did I miss CJag's analysis? Not yet. I haven't done it yet. I forgot about the analysis. Yeah, we're gonna do that in a bit. But no, I'm shilling Paripi Komei to him. Oh, I'm dead. I died. We just been talking.
I was shilling your boy Kong Ming to him. So he hears this girl sing, right? And he becomes mesmerized by her singing. And he was like, you know what? The afterlife isn't so bad after all. Then he finds out that, you know what? You're not dead. You're just in the future. And then he was like, you know what? Because you took care of me. So the girl took care of him, basically. The girl that he heard the singing from. So he was like, since you took care of me, I'll make sure that whatever venture you do in life, it will be a success. Because I have been the tactician to kings. Now I'll be a tactician for you. So basically, Kong Ming becomes this girl's musical agent. And a lot of musical shenanigans happen. One of which is he made sure that she gets like 500 likes on Instagram. And then like booking gigs for her. And right now their next venture is to garner 100,000 likes on Instagram so that they get to sing at this music festival. It's pretty hype, honestly. I'm pretty sure my storytelling is shitty, and I'm not giving it justice, but give it an episode. If you don't like it, you don't like it. It's fine. But like if you were to give it a chance, Patty P. Komei or Ya Boy Kong Ming. Like, that's not me memeing the name. It's literally called Ya Boy Kong Ming. It's hype as fuck. I love that show. A new episode comes out tomorrow. Like, he learns how to rap and shit. It's fucking hype, dude. Anyway, we're gonna do C-Jag's personality test in a bit. C-Jag, pick a number between 1 and 2. This is not the analysis yet. This is just me picking which source material to pull from for you. Between 1 and 2, my friend. 1? Alright, we'll pull from book 1. Then, I'm gonna pull how many topics there are, and then we'll deal with that. Actually, I guess I don't need to wait to kill this guy. We just need to get into one cycle. Once he leaves this area, I'll start doing it. Is he angry? Oh, he's angry. Just give me 1 second. Also, yeah, obviously not, if you're here. Obviously, participate too, please. This is fun with more people, trust. This thing that we're gonna do is really fun with a lot of folks. This is also something you can do with the wife. If you wanna clip what we're gonna be doing, because I'm gonna read the whole thing, and it's something that you wanna share with the wifey, it's fun. Participation was you do best? Damn. How's the Ni no Kuni-ing? Okay, he ran away. Alright, this is a good opportunity for me to do this. Alright. There we go. Alright, we're gonna take a quick break from hunting monsters. Alright. You spent $4 on familiars? Damn. Okay, let's park our dude here first. Then we'll do this. Hello. Alright. Also, we'll do this. There. Alright, book one, right? Okay, from book one. Give me a number between 17 to 171. Oh, the first one? Okay. 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 So, see, Jack, listen very closely, please. And Nauseous as well. This is called The Desert Journey. Okay? Your desktop is spilling over with unfinished paperwork. The rest of the office has already gone home for the night. You look up at the clock and it laughs back. You wonder with a sinking feeling inside if this job will ever be done. The professor drones on and on a 3-hour double lecture on the world's most boring subject. There's no space left for doodles in your notebook, and you're only 30 minutes into the class. You begin to think you've somehow been frozen in time. Waiting can be a special form of torture, worse than any momentary pain. The combination of frustration and boredom can send even the bravest heart into a state of panic. Our first journey, or your journey rather, will bring us face to face with the finite, with the infinite rather, sorry, with the infinite. Take a moment to prepare yourself and enter the eternal desert. You got that? Do you have that? You have that picture in your mind, T-Jag? Let me just read it once more. Waiting can be a special form of torture, worse than any momentary pain. The combination of frustration and boredom can send even the bravest heart into a state of panic. Our first journey will bring us face to face with the infinite. Take a moment to prepare yourself and enter the eternal desert. All right, here we go. You are riding a camel across the vast and empty expanse of a seemingly endless desert. You have ridden until you're near exhaustion. What words do you say to the camel that has carried you all the way? Thanks, homie. I blanked out and tuned out the question. Okay, I'm gonna read it for Nauseous once more. Prepare yourself to enter the eternal desert, Nauseous. You are riding a camel across the vast empty expanse of a seemingly endless desert. You have ridden until you are near exhaustion. What words do you say to the camel that has carried you all the way? Not a fan of it. That's what you tell it? Okay. Scenario 2. Just at the point when you thought you'd die of thirst, a beautiful oasis appears. But someone has arrived before you. Who is this other traveler? You make sure it is doing well? Okay. Once again, just at the point where you thought you'd die of thirst, a beautiful oasis appears. But someone has arrived before you.
Who is this other traveler? It's C-Jag, alright. Sam, all right. Okay. Time passes slowly in the desert, and it feels like an eternity before the lights of a town appear on the horizon. You have finally reached your destination. What are your feelings as you come to your journey's end? Once again, time passes slowly in the desert, and it feels like an eternity before the lights of a town appear on the horizon. You have finally reached your destination. What are your feelings as you come to your journey's end? Exhaustion, okay. Relief, okay. And the final thing. The time has come to part with the camel you have ridden for so long. Just as you dismount, a new rider climbs into the saddle to take your place. Who is the new rider? Baby Azran is the new rider? Doesn't matter. Make them get down, camel needs a break. Okay. Fair enough, fair enough. Okay, are we ready? Those are your final answers. It's Azran. Alright. Okay, okay. The key to the desert journey. The desert and camel theme symbolizes the journey toward personal independence. Specifically, this scenario reveals your feelings about parting with a lover. Your answers show how you might react when the time comes to go your separate ways. The words you spoke to the camel reveal what you might say to yourself when you realize love has been lost. Did you try words of encouragement like, "We'll make it through somehow," or "Don't worry, this can go on forever"? Or was there a hint of despair, "We're lost, this is hopeless, I think we're going to die out here"? So if you guys go back to the answers that you gave, if C-Jag parts ways with someone they love, it'll be, "Thanks, homie." Not will be, "I'll make sure that person is doing well." Alright, next. In psychological terms, the oasis symbolizes the key to solving one's problems. The person you encountered here could be someone who has helped or comforted you in the past, or you might turn to in times of need. Pretty sure C-Jag says his wife. And I'm pretty sure Not says C-Jag. Number three, the town at the journey's end stands for the order restored to your emotions once you've recovered from your broken heart. Your feelings upon reaching the town are your true feelings about finally getting over a lost love. Not says exhaustion, then C-Jag says relief. I don't know how apt this is, because it says the new rider is a person whom you feel a secret rivalry, jealousy, or resentment. I don't think this works out for you, C-Jag. The person you named is a rival in love, or maybe someone who once broke your heart. I don't think it's your baby. Fuck them kids. Anyway, they're not 100%, but I hope you enjoyed that little delve into a game of self-discovery, I guess, is a better way to to present it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. That was still fun. All right. I mean, again, it's not 100%. Again, like the book, this book that I'm pulling from is very old. It's I See No One as a Rival. Yep. Yeah. that actually checks out, Nauseous. But yeah, not to be the armchair psychologist, but it could also be the Elektra complex for CJAG. But then again, it's an old. I was seeing not rival Ashley. He's been trying to fight Ezran. Oh no, no, don't fight the baby. I'm gonna do it too. Oh no, he's a baby. Don't do it. He's but a child. I like this book. It's outdated. I'll be the first to admit it's outdated. And at this point, it's not really like a good psychological evaluation, right? Obviously, it's not. It's good fun. It's good clean fun. Telling to stop to deserve stop deserving to be fought. Oh no. What activities do you guys do with the baby? With Ezran? What's his favorite thing to do? Are you guys gonna expose him to video games early on? Or will you be a bit more strict when it comes to that? Because obviously, like, we play video games, obviously. So we understand that it's not like how our older parents demonized it to be. Obviously it's not. And a lot of it is very helpful as well. Right? Like it develops problem solving skills, hand-eye coordination, all that good stuff, right? Will you be the kind of parent who will actively encourage your child to play video games? I'm gonna let him play pretty early. Just manage what he plays and how much. That's good. Yeah, because like I mean, I guess in a way you still need to like you can't have your child play, say for example, League of Legends at like age, I don't know, 10, and then he's exposed to all that toxicity. Told him if he raises that iPad baby, I'ma throw hands. Oh no, oh no. You're pretty hands-on, though. The interactions I've seen with you, at least, it's not a lot, right? It's what you share on screen. Obviously, that's not the full story. That's not the full. But at least from what I see, you're a pretty hands-on dad, and I kind of respect you for that a lot. That's it. It's pretty cool. Want to play with Gibson and not use his track? That's true. You want to enjoy times with him. I'll tell you guys right now, one core memory I have was playing chess with my dad. I remember my dad would come home from work. He'll say he's very exhausted. So what he'll do is he'll ask me to set up the chessboard for him. Right? We'll set up the chessboard. While he's in bed, and then he'll tell me what his moves are, and then he'll just, you know, fade away into sleep while we're playing. That was a core memory that I personally developed from my father, and I think I'd be a very different person if my dad didn't do that for me. You know? Like, he was exhausted. I get it. Now that I'm an adult with responsibilities, like, I fucking lie down for 2 minutes and I'm, like, sleeping. After work, holy shit. So, like, him taking the time, like, now that I'm an adult, like, maybe, honestly, growing up, I think I kind of resented him a little bit for, like, oh, why did he, like, not take our playtime seriously? Like, why did he choose to sleep while playing? Like, he wasn't serious. And now that I'm, like, an adult with my own responsibilities, and it was like, you know what? He took the time to actually, like, do all of that for me. Oh, shit. I have 5 minutes left. I didn't even notice. I forgot there was a time limit. Yeah, like, I didn't realize that, oh. I can capture this guy. Perfect. There we go. We got him. Holy shit. That was cutting it close. Yeah, like, I want to be that way. Like, after work, it's hard to be able to play 100%, but Lisa was trying. Yeah. Like, I guess as a child, like, I didn't really realize that was what he was doing. Like, there was some parts of me that was like, yeah, it was fun playing with him, but, like, he looked tired all the time, and he was, like, not really interested in playing with me, because he would fall asleep, like, mid-game, he would fall asleep, and I was like, and now, again, like, now that I'm an adult, it's like, you know what, he took the time to do that. Like, I put myself in his place, like, fuck that, I'm not gonna fucking play... I'm not fucking playing chess with a random ass kid. Yeah, we don't understand being tired as kids, that is true. Like, absolutely. Yeah. I'm not fucking spending fucking 2 minutes with a child. But then you realize that, oh, you know what? That was actually pretty pog. Yeah, he actually took the time, the effort to spend some time with me as a snotty kid, and I should be more thankful. But then again, I'm not a father, so I wouldn't really know what kind of. I guess I can't put myself. Obviously, you can. Like the level of sacrifices that you would put for your son. I can't wrap my head around it. Not yet, or I don't know if I ever will. Probably not. I don't want to procreate. Like, one of me is enough. I can barely take care of me. You know? Why add more to this world? We're gonna go kill these double Diabloses. I'll probably wrap up on this one too. I'm actually not feeling too good tonight. I ate so much and I think my blood pressure is spiking. I wanna rest. See, and I'm gonna go have a kid. I still have a long way to go. I can't believe he is almost a year old. Aww. When is his birthday? You've never lost a chest? Did I say chest? I'm sorry. I have an accent, okay? I have an accent. June 5th. Oh my goodness, it's almost his birthday. My god. Are you okay? Here's the thing. I read it. Okay, thank you. How will you celebrate your kid's first birthday? This is because I've only played 5 to 6 games since I could turn. Pogs. Question. I don't know what camp you guys side on. I honestly don't have a horse in the race. Will you guys heavily celebrate your child's early birthdays? Because there is that school of thought that says, you know what, the child's not gonna remember this, so why put on a big show? You know what I'm saying? Will you be those kinds of parents that, you know what, Ezran's not gonna remember this, it's better if we, like, say for example, save the money, put it towards his future, or maybe a bigger birthday that he can remember? Like, how are you guys gonna go about that? We'll hang out with our family, but not inviting too many people. Ooh. I'm part of these parties are for you, not the kid. Team parties not are for you. So you would definitely, like, hold, like, a big gathering. Or, like, you'll celebrate the birthday. No, not at all. Oh, it's more like, let's invite a couple of friends over. That kind of thing. Because, like, you know what I'm talking about, right? There are some parents who, like, they go absolutely extravagant for, like, the first birthday. I mean, like, I get it. I understand. I get the kid a smash cake and then post a photo to online. Oh, there we go. We will get him a smash cake thing for fun, but not making it a big thing. Ah. Because going all out is a waste that early. Yeah, that's like, personally, if I were to throw my hat in there, I'm probably part of that, like, thinking as well. Because, like, again, yeah, you celebrate birthdays because, well, you're celebrating the person. But at the same time, it's like, they will not remember. they're not going to remember it. But also, you kind of want, I guess I do see the value in, you kind of want to have photos or memories to look back on. Then you can share that memory with your child. But, like, just, you know, spending all of that time, effort, and money that early on. Exactly. Save it for things he needs on the next birthday, right? Now, like, I don't know how private this question, next question I have is going to be. Like, kid will have their time. That's true. Okay, don't answer this if you don't feel comfy. Like, are you guys the kind of parents who will try to, like, send your kid to as many classes and whatnot as they can, as you can? Like, have them have taekwondo early on, piano lessons, violin lessons, swimming lessons, all of that shenanigans? Or are you guys just like, let them have whatever interest they want? If they present interest and they ask, we'll send them, but otherwise, no. And again, if you don't want to answer, that's fine. I feel like that might be pushing boundaries a bit, so it's okay. Again, I'm just, like, really curious because I'm probably not going to have kids on my own. More than likely. So I'm like, I'm just asking. I was like, oh, how's that gonna work out? I want to introduce him to certain things, but I don't want to push him to do anything. Oh, okay, fair enough. Like, I haven't gotten baby Ez any gifts yet, just some wall art for the parents to put in his room. What wall art did you get? I'm gonna research a bit of this monster we're gonna kill next. Weak against ice, so I guess what we're wearing right now is perfect. Oh, paralysis is bigger. I guess this works. Like, I will introduce theater as an idea, but if that's not what he likes, then I'll learn to love what he loves. Oh, fair enough. That's good. Up to dad here if he wants to reveal the art. Fair enough. I apologize if I have so many questions.
Asking questions is kind of like what I do. That's what I do in life. I apologize. Oh yeah, actually, I was sidetracked. There was something else I was gonna ask you. So, from the sound design or sound technician, curiosity is my strongest trait. Oh, that's true. So I was gonna ask. And again, like, feel free to just like tell me, like, you know what? I don't want to answer that. Like, honestly, like, I get it. Sometimes I get too much when it comes to like asking questions. What's the job progression for like sound technician? Like, do you kind of like want to have your own, like, I don't want to say firm, but kind of like services that you could like present to clients that might have that kind of need? Like, basically, what's the career progression for a job like sound technician? Like, are you aiming to work in a studio? Because you definitely can, right? Like, is that the natural progression there? Working for like a big production studio? Like, I'm just curious. Because, like, again, like, I can't do what you're doing, like, honestly. Like, I know I stream, but like, sound is one of the bigger mysteries in life for me when it comes to this kind of thing. And I'm just like, I'm really impressed and amazed of people like you who can do stuff like that and understand what goes on in the technical side of things. Like, you're probably hearing my own personal setup right now and you're like, oh, this is so like bad. And I'm like, you know, because I don't know what I'm doing, basically. Right on time. Ooh. All right on time. I currently work for a production company, but not a great one. To be honest, I could get into a better one, but my real dream is to run theater and not be in charge of the tech at the theater and be in charge of the tech. Ah, so you want to do your own like theater group? Like, you do all the production and all that? Because that would be dope. Not even gonna lie, that would be dope. What's those bigger theaters in the Broadway Strip? Like, is it Andrew Lloyd Webber? Is that what it is? Because again, I'm like, I'm a pedestrian when it comes to these kinds of things. I'm sure both of you guys know more than I. Is that one of the bigger ones? Is that correct even? I guess I'm not sure. That is a real one? Okay, I was just pulling that out of my ass. I wasn't even sure. But I'm glad that was correct. Okay. Now that I'm like thinking about what you do, it goes beyond just theater, right? Like, you could be working for like, say, comedy clubs, big stadiums, like all that kind of sort of stuff.
It's just like there's a massive horizon for you, my friend. It's kind of amazing. Like, honestly. Like, imagine, like, working for the entertainment business like that. Like, say, for example, you get a massive client. Say, for example, like, in a stand-up comedy kind of thing. Like maybe, like, somebody like Dave Chappelle or something like that. I just wanted something to help show kids how theater can be help you out of your shell, things like that. Ooh, well, that's a very noble cause. And here I am spouting things like Dave Chappelle. You know what I'm saying? I'm very corporate. I'm a sellout, as you notice. Speaking of selling out, I applied to Capcom recently. I applied to be a creator for Capcom. So Capcom, hi! If you're analyzing my content right now, hello. Hopefully you guys say yes so I could be part of the creator program. I really want to host tournaments with Capcom games on it, so let me do it. This Diablos is just batting me around, man. Jeez. What kind of... You do acting as well, right? So what kind of roles do you prefer? I've done sound for tons of different things and love having stories. Like, I've done a sound for demo derbies, rodeos, bands, dog shows, and all that sort of thing. Ooh, yo, that's pretty cool. Like, yeah, there's like... there's so many. Like, just outside... Like, the more I think about it, it's like... The more there's so many avenues for you to work with. Especially in today's day and age, holy... I tend to be a dance-heavy supporting character early. Oh, do you do dance as well? What kind of dance do you do? Have you tried TikTok content creation, my friend? Because if I can dance, I would totally do that. I would totally be a TikToker if I could dance, holy. Oh, did it run away? No, it's right. It's still right here, right? Wait, what? Did it sleep? I don't have formal dance training. Just learn from experience. Jazz ballet style, though. Ooh, yo, that's fancy. When I was... Before COVID. Before the COVID times. Is this a different one? I think this is a different one. It's a smaller one. Before the COVID times, I was physically active in the gym, but that's like the extent of my physical activity. Like, anything fun, like dancing, I'd have two left feet. Maybe I should focus on the other one first, right? How do you get into dancing? The Christmas Carol show I was talking about, I play a character who was able to do a triple barrel turn. I don't even know. That sounds fucking like an anime attack. What do you mean by triple barrel turn? Dude, that sounds like... That sounds like missiles should be coming out of your body. Triple barrel turn! That's pretty fucking dope, dude. Anything with the word triple and barrel in the same phrase, that's gonna be fucking dope. Do a barrel roll! That's right. I'm just swinging my axe here. Yeah, I'm really amazed at people who can do a lot of like physical capabilities. Because I can't. It's exactly what it sounds like. Sarah introduced me to dance. Ah. Nauseous, did you dance as well if you're still here? Dude, I cannot dance for the life of me. I've dabbled in music, but like dancing, absolutely not. Oh shit, look, they're fighting. Ooh, that was big. I would dance in musicals, never on my own. Ooh, what kind of dance did you do? I taught at a dance studio doing third classes and then learned some things from the other teachers. Yo, that's pog. Like, what kind of dance? Like just ballet dancing? I guess that's just what you told me earlier. Like, jazz ballet? Is it more of like a exercise kind of thing? Or is it, like, for presentation as well? Again, like, if my question seemed like this guy doesn't know what he's talking about, because I don't. I really don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just asking, because, like, I don't know. So hopefully my questions aren't, like, I don't know. It really does come from a place of ignorance, my questions. Because, again, like, I'm not really exposed to these kinds of things too much. I jumped into some of the ballet classes to help the young boys feel more comfortable, but I tried a bunch of other types too. Oh. Like, because boys might find it a bit more feminine, so they're looking for a more of a role model, I guess. Is that right? Or I could be wrong again. Like, I'm coming from a place of ignorance here. Oh, okay, there we go. I guessed right. That's pretty cool, man. Like, I guess I never did anything like... The closest thing I would have done for something that... of that sort of thing would be... I was in a band. It wasn't even a good band. My director here thought it would encourage more boys to join. The only one that was in the class. Ah. It actually worked in the three boys. Okay, that's cool. The campaign worked, more inclusivity. Right? I was in a band. I was in multiple bands, like, growing up. Just need to show them it's a sport like anything else. That's true. I guess there is that bit of a stigma, especially with, like, young boys. A bunch of them are dickheads. I would know I was one of them, right? I was a young boy once. I was a dickhead. And like a lot of like very false stigmas when it comes to like I guess like way back when it comes to dance and whatnot. Especially ballet, right? Yeah, I was a dickhead too. That's why I want to help kids that age realize they're being dickheads. That is true. The biggest help you could give a young teenage lad would be to make them realize that you're being a dickhead. Because like 99% of the time, they're being dickheads. If I were to hold a foundation, it would be the Limit RX Try Not to Be a Dickhead Youth Foundation for dickhead kids to lessen their being a dickhead. Our foundation aims to make sure that young lads stop being dickheads. Or at least lessen. I'll sign up for that foundation. right. Right next to the Zoolander Institution for kids who don't read too well. It's gonna be epic. Speaking of kids, do you plan on having more kids? Again, if you don't feel comfy answering, that's fine. I'm just curious, because like you're a father. It's a situation that I will most likely never be. You love Zoolander? Zoolander is awesome. But are you open to having more children in the future? Because my parents, they were one and done. My parents were like, you know what? Life is rough. When we have this one kid, he's probably gonna be a dickhead. We have enough dickheads in the world. We'll just take care of this one. We don't plan to have one more because Sam hated being pregnant. Oh, I understand. Yeah, pregnancy sucks. Like, okay, here, real talk. I was a nurse for a bit. Also, money. Yeah, that's true. Like, raising kids are fucking rough and expensive. Before I get into my other story, what car seat did you get for Ezran? Because those are scams, dude. Holy. Hopefully something I can adopt. Ez or a cousin or something. Steal Ezran. They won't know. Replace him with the emote. What car seat did you get, Ezran? C-Jag. Because I tell you, a cousin for him. A cousin for him. Okay, fair enough. Because I worked for Toys R Us for a bit. Toys R Us, Babies R Us. And those fucking shits are scams. Not gonna lie. Like, why does a car seat unopened, why does a car seat unopened have a fucking expiration date on them? You tell me. Safety first, good choice. Safety first is a very good choice. It's not crazy expensive, and they meet all the standards, and pretty nice designs too. Safety first is pretty good. Back when I was working for Babies R Us, that was one of our like top sellers. But have you seen the race car car seats? Is it Redico? Was it Redero? Something like that. Like fucking $1,000 for that shit, and they expire in 2 years. Like what? Can someone explain that shit to me? I've worked for Toys R Us for a year. I could not wrap my head around why a fucking baby seat has an expiry date. Like honestly, dude, I'm not even. I think it's Recaro. Pretty sure, Recaro. It was $1,000 Canadian. $1,000 Canadian, those Ricardo car seats. Like, I'm not even bullshitting you. They're so fucking expensive. Like, safety first is like, what? $150, $200, right? Give or take? Like, I don't know, in US, maybe it's a bit cheaper for you guys. A bit more cheaper. Because everything is inflated in Canada. But it's somewhere around that price point, right? A little shy of 100, a little, maybe past, a little past. Maybe 200, right? That's reasonable. For me, at least. Well, I guess, compared to the shits that I was seeing working for Toys R Us, like, that's reasonable to me. You know, you're not, like, breaking the bank or anything. You're fine. Oh, your grandmother got it. Oh, that's good. But yeah, if I were to take a guess how much it is, it was probably like $100, something, give or take, right? Like, it's not cheap, right? It's not cheap, but it's not like crazy expensive. And it's for the child safety, obviously. You want to get the best, at least. But like, not like fucking Recaro, that's like $1,000, holy shit. Yeah, like that fucking baby seats are a scam, dude. They're like big scam ass. I'm not even gonna front. They're big scam. Big big car seat strikes again. Not once you get your own kid, be wary of the big car seat gouging you for prices. They sell us new parents senseless scams. That is true. Holy man. That is true. Cause they prey upon your fears. Right? Cause obviously you guys are scared. Like, it's your first child. You want to make everything right. You want to make sure everything is right. You don't want to like fuck it up early on. And all these baby companies scam you out of your money. Because they know you guys will buy it. Because, like, what are you going to do? Not buy it? You could very well adopt an older kid. Prove them they aren't undesirable. Oh, that's good. Want your baby to feel... Dude, that's... You know what else is big on scamazes? Fucking baby monitors. Holy, oh shit. Why did this guy fall into the fucking pit? It's like this tiny dinky thing. Your baby will die if you don't buy this. My god. That's so scummy to me, honestly. It's like, what are parents gonna do? Like, honestly, like, what? Like, I get it. Like, maybe on your first, on your second romp as a parent, like, you're probably gonna be a bit more smart with your purchases, because you'll know what the child actually needs, as opposed to what you thought they needed. But like, at the same time, it's like, you know, they've already scammed you out of your money, of your hard-earned money. Like, raising a kid is hard enough. You know? Wife is calling on her way. I'm gonna have to... Yo, C-Jag, thanks for hanging out tonight, man. Appreciate it, for real. I hope you had fun. Thanks for talking to me, man. Appreciate it. I learned a lot. Thank you. Have a good night, man. And say hello to the baby for me, man. Oh my goodness. Thanks for the biddies, man. Holy. Thank you so much. My goodness. Anyone watching this on YouTube in the future, follow my friend CJAG_17, twitch.tv/CJAG_17. Awesome guy, has a cute baby, plays a lot of fun games. He was playing Smash the other week, and he was playing Roller Champions. It's a roller derby game. Pretty fun. Hang out on this stream. You'll see me there too. Ooh. All right, let's do this. Let's do this Diablo in and end his suffering. This is probably our last hunt for the night as well. I kind of want to rest. I'm really tired. I just wanted to make sure that I had a stream in this evening. Just so that I'm not skipping days. Get that algorithm in. But I really do enjoy playing this game on stream. It's really fun. And we're gonna have more fun as we go along too, as honestly. Like when Sunbreak comes out, oh my god, it's gonna be so much fun. I need to catch up. I'm not caught up yet. There's a lot more work I need to do. But we're getting there, bit by bit. It was really fun. All right. Oh, almost exactly 2 hours. Look at me. Okay, can we do one more thing before we head out? Maybe one more thing. Let's see. My hunts are long, dude. Take forever to hunt. I'm HR70, I think. Maybe we could do one more. One more for the road. I'm pretty sure I have a Rajong weapon. Right? I have one, right? Because I'm of the opinion, maybe I should make a... Yeah, I should make a lightning weapon, which I kind of do have actually. There's a power file, that's pretty good. I have this, Undying Light. Elemental file though. And I have it too. Oh wait, why would I make that when I can make this? Right? This is a better lightning weapon. I need an Orb of Origin though. 43 lightning? What is this? 22 lightning. And 20 damage. Yeah, it definitely offsets. Yeah, it offsets the damage. And I can even upgrade it later. So you know what? Last thing we'll do tonight. I'll redo the Narwa Ibushi quest. All Mother quest. We'll do that for the last bit of tonight. Because I need the orb.
Then let's check in on our minions. Our Meowsenaries. No. Take all. Okay, maybe we should go steal from the oh wait. Oh, I did not even know that was a quest that I need to do. There's something we need to grab here real quick. I forgot. Oh yeah, here. We need to grab the stuff from the nest. There we go. Oh look, it's a Kohoot. Okay, got some Lagni apples. Perfect. What do we have in abundance right now? Gourmet fish? Huh. Okay, fair enough. What else? Roggy hide? Yeah, let's sell off that. Okay, let's read up on what Ibushi and Narwa are weak to. Slicing, but oh, they're weak to dragon. Okay, fair enough. Dragon and ice, actually. So I would be best served if I loaded up a dragon weapon. Do I have one? Is the question. Might be nice. But like I do have the dragon effect. Thank you.
Because this is both... This is both that, right? You can either use this or this one. Hmm. But how much though? How much does it increase it? It's not very open with me here. This is not very open to interpretation. You know? We're missing latent power. Hey Farron, I'm actually about to close out. Do you wanna hunt with me for this last hunt for tonight? Yeah, I'll put a thing up. All right. How do I make a room? How are you tonight, Farron? Movie night? Ooh, what movie are you watching? I introduced my buddy to the Eurovision movie. Wait, hold on. You know what? I think friends of mine are also watching that. It's cheesy as fuck with fun. Ooh, what's it about? Like, I haven't watched myself, but I heard a couple of friends of mine actually talking about it. I'm not entirely sure if it's the same thing, but it might. It's starring Will Ferrell. It's about two Icelandic singers competing in the Eurovision. I think I've heard of that, actually. Yeah. I don't know how happy I am with this weapon right now. Because... Let me see if I can upgrade it. Oh, this is already the upgraded version. Damn. That's a fancy ass switch axe. It's the Ibushi switch axe. Because I want a dragon weapon.
Then I want a lightning weapon too, so I'm killing this monster so I can make this one. I'm literally at the point where I'm just like making endgame weapons. Alright, I'm ready when you're ready. Oh wait, I didn't even post the quest, I'm an idiot. We're doing the All Mother quest. I'm gonna pee real quick, BRB. I am exhausted from the day. Alright, let's rock. Let's get the show on the road. Alright, this is our last quest for the night, friends. Midnight music. Midnight cruising with Limit and Farron here on Twitch.tv/LimitRx. I'm so exhausted. I feel like even if I play every night though, I feel like I'm not gonna catch up to Sunbreak. Like, I'm not gonna finish all of these quests. Thanks for the cannonballs, nerd. I can't tell if I'm doing more damage with this build. I really can't tell. Look at that, you gave me a spot to jump on so I don't get hit by your laser beam attack. Look at you and your benevolent nature. I missed the train. There we go, I got one. Oh, this guy's almost dead, holy. Oh, we're very quick with this. There we go. Cutscene! Cutscene, baby! Why is my audio mono? What is going on with my mic? There we go. Oh, there we go. It's Narwa! She's gonna eat her boyfriend! Need a horn. Did we kill Ibushi so fast he didn't break anything on him? Wow. First hunter problems. Killed the monster so fast. Yeah, I think I am doing more damage, to be honest. To be fair, I think I am doing more damage with this build. As opposed to like a crit build. Because I'm still technically critting. Right? That's not gone. And it's just more apropos here, because I'm actually doing an element that Narwa's weak to. So I don't know the conversion there, if it's like percentage damage. But the fact that I'm using a power file too. Oh, did it? Oh, let me knock your head, please. That's kind of cool.
I like this gimmick that they put with Narwa. I think I'm doing a lot more damage with this weapon. Like, not gonna lie. I really think I am. Yeah, I'm definitely doing a lot more. This is good that I transferred my build. And the fact that I don't get stunned in this one, just making sure that I can unga bunga to my fullest, keep dishing out that damage. Oh, we have a tail? There's a tail, let me cut this tail. Ooh, there we go. Spark sack. I don't need that. I need an origin orb. Oh shit, I didn't notice. Sorry, Farin. Oh, I should have paid attention. She double tap? Damn. Oh my god, please don't dodge my shit. Not gonna lie though, I'm not too impressed with the Narwa design. Like, it's great, don't get me wrong, it looks good, but I feel like they could have done better. Like, the Narwa Ibushi design, I feel like it's a bit lacking. I can keep on hitting while Farin rams 5 tons of Magnum Molo on top of this Narwa. Let me on this. That was it. That's very reminiscent of Safi Jiva's super. Not gonna lie.
They need new moves. Yeah, if I have stun resistance, like, it's actually very hard for Narwa to kill me. It's because that's usually when they do their kills. I'm not paying attention to my team. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Sorry, my goodness. I apologize. I should pay attention more. Holy shit. You know what it is? It's because Farron is a very good hunter, so I'm like less inclined to like monitor. Like, hands down, Farron is a better hunter than I. I'm just a bit, over-farmed, that's why I'm surviving these. Even though technically I should be dying as well. I think I'm good, but I'm really bad getting clunk a second time as soon as I get up. You are good though, like, for real, like, your mechanical skill is like 10 times better than mine, 100%. It's just that I'm a bit overstated because I like building for defense. And I might die here too, hold on. Okay. We're almost there, we just need to take it home. We had the Magnamalo event already. So this Narwa is about dead. I got you this time. Oh my god, she dodged. Ooh, that is a hard knockdown, holy. Oh, she's almost dead. Got this, we're almost there. Nice wind, nerd. Oh, we got a topple. Nice. Nice. Well played, Farron.
The color scheme for this monster is really nice too. Just that I feel like the design could have made could have used a bit more improvement. Like I like it. The yellow and the blue and the gold, it's nice. I need an orb. Give me an orb. Bet money it's not gonna give it to me because I have the desire sensor now. Yeah, that was it. Let's see in the post. The post farm. You have three orbs? I need one. I need one origin orb so that I could make the narwhal weapon. So that I have a lightning weapon. I don't want to use Rajong. Because of the sharpness, it's so bad. But then again, I could put in Slugger, right? It has that Slugger thing or whatever. Like, the more blunt your weapon is, the better it is. But I kind of like... I like cutting stuff, so...
Yes.
I didn't get an orb, unfortunate. Do you want to run it again? Do you want to run it again, Farron? How opposed are you to us running it again? You want to do a run back? The problem with Narwa is I'm spoiled by most monsters not being able to smack me in the air. Yeah, that's true. I gotta say it again. I just need one orb. Just give me one orb, game. Just give me one orb. That's all I want. And she's like, sit down, peasant. Let's see if there's a food that increases rewards post. Let's see. Money maker. No, not really. Oh yeah, Farron. So I learned the volcano route. So yeah, I'm kind of rolling in money now. Yeah, I'm rolling in money now too. I learned the route. Like it took me like 15 minutes to learn. I should have just done that to begin with, to be honest. Yeah, it's so good. It's so annoyingly good, actually. Like, if you want money, set aside 30 minutes, and you can get like a million. Easy. Alright. You know what I'm struggling now for? Hard armor. Armor piece, like the armor thingies. Like I know how to farm for them, like I just gotta hunt those rock lizards. But it's so tedious. It's actually so tedious to do. Yes, spheres are annoying as fuck to do. It's like, it's not even efficient. Hold on. So let's play a good song for the last hunt of the night. I know I said that last time, but you know. Hold on. Let's rock. Okay. Alright, Ibushi, let's do this! I'm using your weapon, Ibushi! Are you poisoned? Did you catch COVID, Ibushi? What the hell? Oh my god, you roared me out of my thing. Can't wait until the master gear that has like all the slots. So I could put earplugs. I could put earplugs on one of my things. Oh god damn it. Why aren't you dropping? We popped all of the cannons. What? Oh, really? I missed? Ibushi, oh god. Ibushi used his wind attack. It was very effective. It was super effective. Oh, what? I reloaded mid-air, come on. There we go, we popped him. Oh my god, he's almost dead too. We do so much damage. He's dying before we can cut shit. Oh shit, come on. He's dead. Okay. Aren't you like gonna eat your boyfriend or something? Go do that. playing very poorly in this round. Like, if I wasn't running stun resistance, I would have been stunned three times over. Oh, I couldn't have a chance to use it. I need to sharpen. Maybe once Magna Malos comes in. I just realized I legitimately just shut up in that period. I was like, oh shit, I should be talking because I'm streaming. Oh, we got a tail. Was it a tail? Was that actually a tail? That was a tail. Nice. Pog. I guess it's a fun fight and all, but I feel like it should be more. Oh shit, I didn't notice. Am I dead? No, live. Ooh. Oh, I fucked up, I'm sorry. I didn't eat my ancient potion fast enough. Alright, let's reload on resources. That bitch over here! Yo, the water physics though, look at this water physics though. Look at this shit, it's beautiful. Has it always been that beautiful? Holy. Also, where is Magna Malo? Do we not have enough damage on it yet? Oh my god, I can't fly away from it. That was a hard knockdown, holy. Oh, I dodged that. No, oh, there we go. Dude, this hard knockdown is annoying. Because even if you have stun resistance, you're just like sleeping for a hot minute. Oh, there we go. There's the Astra. Can sharpen. Wait, hold on. Teostra? Wait, what? It changes? Wait, I just realized that Teostra, hello? Excuse, has this ever happened to you, Farron? Because as far as I know, it's supposed to be Magnamalo over here. What? Did Magnamalo call in sick? What is going on? Did he ask for this? Did he ask for PTO? Did the manager approve this? What's going on? The fuck? I've never seen this happen before. Since when did Teostra be part of... I've never seen Teostra be part of this whole shenanigans. You know what I'm saying? Oh god, oh god. I did it wrong. I over jumped. There we go, I got it anyway. What? Did Narwa just have invul frames right there? Oh god, no, not like this. Trust in me, and I say. Oh God. Oh god, no, 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 not like this. There we go. And if it's quite alright. Oh, she's gonna do the drill move. Oh, I love this song. Let's go, let's go. Oh,
only 90s kids will remember. I see that double dodge. Once in a while, I know what I'm doing. Every other time, I know what I'm doing. Oh god, not the drill move again. Can you not? Oh my god, not like this. There we go. Got the belly. Okay, let's just take it home. Almost there. Oh my god, stop roaring at me, please. Yeah, I don't see the best. The best place to be when she's doing that is... Oh, what? Oh, I thought I got hit. I was gonna cry foul if I got hit by that. Oh my god. There's way too many close calls here in this run. Oh, there we go. Woo! That was tight. Look at that. Oh, those are very nice colors. Good job, good job. No, you the best, Farian. Holy. I really fumbled in that last run. I got hit way too many times. Come on, give me a Gemerald. Come on, give me a Gemerald. Don't be... Also, that was the first time I've seen that, Farron. Theostra coming in instead of Magnamalo? That was wacky, number one. Like, who invited him? Look at this mouth, that's weird. That's weird and wacky. It's like an unhinged mouth. Right? You've seen Kushala come in before? I've never seen it. I guess I haven't farmed this guy as much. Okay, give me a Gemerald, goddammit. No Gemerald. The desire sensor is strong. They know I want it. They know I want it. God damn it. They fucking know. They know. Okay, you know what? It's almost 2 a.m. I gotta call it quits. Anyway. Anyway. Moonlight. Deki Nai Midnight. Anyway, thank you so much for hanging out tonight. CJAG, thanks so much for the raid. Thank you so much for the bits. That's 34 bits. Thank you so much, my friend. If you guys want to watch some cool content, watch my good friend CJAG_17 at twitch.tv/CJAG_17. And of course, my very good friend Farron de Celier. And of course, Nauseous, thank you so much for hanging out tonight. You guys are awesome. Kingdom Reaper, thank you so much for following as well. And of course, the CJAG raid, you guys are awesome. I'm gonna go play more. The Desire Sensor Punishes All. Thank you for hanging out tonight, Farron. You're the best. Let's play more Monhun, and let's play more Monhun when Sunbreak comes out as well. We need to catch up. I need to catch up. I need to start farming what's his face? Valstrax. Like, I just need to get there. Like, and I hate having the rampage just undone, but like, we'll try and finish all the event quests. There's a lot of event quests that aren't done. In the coming days, we'll do that. I should probably stream earlier. I'm just like super exhausted when I get home. I love that monster, but whenever I hear that name, Valstrax. Ask your doctor. Yeah, right. Ask your doctor if Valstrax is right for you. Right? Jesus Christ. Anyway, that was fun. It's so much fun hunting monsters, but it's like a long thing to do. And it's like, I love Monster Hunter, but there's so much work to be done. Anyway, I'm rambling. We'll play more tomorrow. I'll sleep early tonight so I can actually stream early tomorrow. With that being said, have an awesome life. Have an awesome night. Thank you for coming to Slam. Don't forget your blazing. Bye-bye. Let's finish the song. Miracle Romance. Bye.